Desde Génesis hasta... ¿Ese es Malaquías?
Malaquías.
Desde Génesis a Malaquías. Ese es el antiguo. Y a, aquí está también el Nuevo Testamento. Miren, es desde Mateo hasta Apocalipsis. ¿Apocalipsis?
Apocalipsis.
Ajá.
Thank you.
¿Allá es donde empezamos?
Yeah.
¿Allá es donde empezamos?
No.
No va. Parece.
I've always imagined the Garden of Eden as the epitome of beauty. God made that garden a home for the first two people. It was all very good. True beauty. It was easy to believe as a kid. As I got older, I learned about Earth being billions of years old. And it challenged my ideas about that garden. It meant that for billions of years, animals lived, suffered, and died.
Yeah.
If all of this happened long before Adam and Eve, then how could God view his creation as very good? For years, I struggled to fit billions of years into my beliefs about creation. It never satisfied me. I mean, if God made a world full of death and disease, what would that say about his character? Did he like suffering and death? Recently, I began to realize there's millions and billions of years of God by the chain.
La creación de Dios. Estamos ya en la creación de Dios. En el
jardín de Eden. Created, and the Lord God brought every beast of the field and every bird of the air to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. Ha'el natagan be'eden b'mizrach. The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden.
Miren, qué
hermoso. The man whom he had created. And the Lord God brought every beast of the field and every bird of the air to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put
precioso, precioso, precioso. Ay, mi pingüino. Miren lo que yo más amo. Ahí está Adán.
And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. Ha'el natah gan be'eden b'mizrach. The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden. And there he put the man whom he had created. And the Lord God brought every beast of the field and every bird of the air to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. The Lord God planted a garden eastward in Eden, and there he put the man whom he had created. And the Lord God brought every beast of the field and every bird of the air to Adam to see what
Adán y Eva.
The Lord God said, it is not not good that the man should be alone.
Ahí está Adán y Eva.
I will make a helper fit for him. The Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he took one of his ribs and made it into a woman, and brought her to the man. And Adam said, she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. The Lord God said, it is not good that the man should be alone. I will make a helper fit for him. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon Adam, and he took one of his ribs and made it into a woman, and brought her to the man. And Adam said, she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. And they were both naked, the man and his wife.
Curioseando. Qué metida Eva. Hermoso.
The Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat of it, for in the day that you eat thereof, you shall surely die. And if you are not eat your bowl, the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat of it. And in the day that you eat thereof, you shall surely die. The Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat of it. For in the day that you eat thereof, you shall surely die. The Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat, but of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat of it. For in the day that you eat thereof, you shall surely die. The serpent said to the woman, has God really said you should not eat of every tree of the garden?
God said we will die.
The serpent said to the woman, you shall not surely die. The woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes and the tree to be desired to make one wise. She took of the fruit and did eat, and also gave to her husband with her, and he did eat. And the eyes of both of them were open, and they knew they were naked. The serpent said to the woman, has God really said you should not eat of every tree of the garden?
God said you will die.
The serpent said to the woman, you shall not surely die.
Throughout history, it still affects our lives to this day. Evil such as slavery taint the history of our nation. It still impacts our country. Slavery was not for exists in the form of human trafficking, enslaving 20 to 30 million people around the world, with tens of thousands of people trafficked every year in the United States. We see sin permeate our homes, creating discord and abuse within the family.
To Abel and to his offering, but we have much respect to Cain and to his offering. And Cain was very angry, and Cain rose up against Abel his brother.
Centuries of my life, I knew Adam. Adam's oldest son was Cain. You know, the one who killed his brother Abel. Through the line of Cain came industry, metalworking, music, art. But along the way, they forgot all about God and just chose to live their own way. Years ago, God spoke to my grandson, Noah, and warned him that he would send a flood to destroy every living thing that moves on the face of the earth. God told Noah to build a great ship, an ark. And you know what? It's almost finished. I have survived 969 years. My time is nearly over. With each passing day, judgment draws nearer.
Something terrible is coming. Back up, she's going to come through.
You're going to arrive, thank you. Sorry, buddy.
That was me. That was our fault. All right.
Thank you.
She again bore his brother. In the process of time, Cain brought the bruise of an offering to the Lord.
Oh, ahí está el building del arte de Noé, mi bebé. Cuando lo construyeron. Pasemos. Ellos están trabajando arriba. Arriba, allá, allá, mire, atrás de usted.
You need to have a look at that new sheet with the blanks and make sure the treatment was done as we told them. By the way, my friend, have you thought about that conversation? God's word is true.
Hey, Zophar! Were those pigs checked by Shem before you sold them off?
Judgment is coming, my friend. But if you come along, you will be safe in the ark.
Oh.
compremos aquí, compremos cebolla, frijoles, zanahoria, ajo. Ya estoy vendiendo yo acá.
Sí.
Ahí está el arca de Noé.
This ark is huge. Now, I know there are different kinds of dinosaurs with many varieties within each kind, but the Lord brought to me two of every kind of dinosaur. And there's only about 50 kinds of what you call dinosaurs. So I only needed around 100. We had to take two of each kind and seven of some. For example, there is a dog kind, a cat kind, a horse kind, and there are many kinds of land animals in the world. So, how did I fit them all in? Well, first of all, this ark is huge. It is over 500 feet long, 80 feet wide, and 50 feet high, with three levels of storage. There's plenty of room. See, I only had to bring the land-dwelling, air-breathing animals, and only two of each kind, and seven of some. Not two of every variety within each kind. For example, I've seen many varieties of dogs, some with long fur, some short, some are large, some small, but God brought only one pair of dogs to represent the dog kind. Because all the dogs, whether big or small, short hair or long, are all part of the same dog kind. Even though they can be quite different, they're still just dogs, right? God sent only one pair for that whole group. The Lord did this for each and every kind of land animal. So you see, we didn't need to bring nearly as many animals on board as you might have thought. Anything else you'd like to know?
Está bonito. Está explicando todo.
No? Okay. You know, I've been wondering when it will be safe to leave. I thought I would send out a raven, or maybe a dove, and see what happens. A bird can fly about and look for a safe place to land, and it can always come back to the ark if there is still water everywhere. I can't see below because the window is at the top, and the side of the ark blocks my view. We can feel and hear that there is still water around the Ark, but we have come to rest and are not floating about anymore. I'll do some of these tests, but really, since the Lord told us when to board the Ark, we will wait for him to tell us when to leave. I think the time is drawing near. It will be wonderful to stand on solid ground again. Still, I imagine it will be a very different world. It will take time for plants and trees to cover the earth again. And the only animals will be the ones that come off the ark with us. As for people, there will be just the eight of us. But God is faithful. He has provided our way of salvation. And he has delivered us from his judgment. Until he tells us in secret, I have much to do. Unless you have been the most
the best way to explain the geological features of the past. Attention museum guests, join us at 1 o'clock for an exploration of the night sky in the interactive program, Astronomy Live with Dr. Danny Faulkner. Tickets are available at Guest Service Information Center. Thank you.
Alguien me está viendo ahí, mire. Alguien me está viendo.
Grande aquí, ¿verdad?
Baños
aquí también, miren.
Sí.
ahí está Adán desnudo y allá está cuando ya, ya había comido la manzana.
El primero y el último. Ajá. El primero Adán y el último Adán.
Ajá. ¿Y aquí es venta o librería?
Venta.
Oh, venta. Y venden cosas. Aquí continuamos para allá, va. La salida, no hay salida acá. Oh, allá dice exit. ¿Sigue para allá?
No,
no
hay
para allá. Oh. Sí, ya pasamos aquí. No sé si hay salida ya.